We're talking about office, so I want to know how to do a tie. So I'm gonna watch a tutorial.
Hello, I'm Charles from Louis Purple.
Hi,
today
Charles.
I'm going to teach you how to tie a Windsor knot. The Windsor knot is actually a very simple knot to tie, and it's very useful because.
Wait, Charles, your spy, your French as well is very useful. Very, very useful. Hein?
Find the right balance depending on the length of your tie. The tie should be in the middle of your neck. So this is wide end through the loop between the collar and the tie.
Okay, mister.
And you bring underneath.
No.
Which should look like this.
Not doing the same, Charles.
To fit your collar. So it's. Which should look like this.
Get it in.
And tighten the knots.
Not good to be married, right? Yeah, well, at least I can advise you some sense. Bonjour, bonjour, fragrance lovers. Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we're talking about top 10 office scent. For me, office scent, what it is, it's a scent that is non-invasive, and that's the thing that is the most important thing to me, because you don't want to intoxicate everyone in the office. I think it's pretty rude, to be honest, to do so. Like, it's nice to spray, like, I mean, in parties, going out, you know, blah, 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 in the street. But when you're in the office and you stay 6 hours or 8 hours in the office in front of the same person, and then they don't like your fragrance, it's pretty offensive. So if you do work in an office, this video is for you. I tried also to offer you some other choice. I gave you 2 safe options, but the rest of it is really something different, because I didn't want to give you all the time the same scent that you can see in all the lists. So I'm showing you today something a bit different, so I hope you'll be enjoying. The first one I wanted to talk about today is Creed Millésime Impérial. I think for me this is the essence of something very ultra classy and non-invasive. What is nice with Creed fragrance is they are not projecting like bismuth, and this is really enjoyable for any time, like office. Elegance doesn't need to shout out. I do really love the all this softness, and what I like specifically is it smells very masculine. It has that freshness just like you've been shaving. It's got a very softness with the sandalwood and the musk that are very creamy, and you've got this really kind of watermelony vibe going on with this fragrance, which is so beautiful. It's really for me more like an aquatic scent as well, very refreshing. And I feel for the office, when you something very important is to smell clean, not smelling like very intense, I would say, woody vibe. It's nice to just smell clean, very delicate. It's got a soft projection. It's, you can really smell a really high quality in the ingredient, because during the time it changes in waves. It's soft, powdery. It's really like having like a bit of a poetic touch. It's really refined, and this is really what I like. And for me, like a scent like this is really pure luxury. So it's very, I think, sparkling and aquatic, and I do love that. And I think for office that would be a perfect match. The next one I'm gonna talk about, it is from Molton Brown, and it's Tobacco Absolute. So I really enjoy Molton Brown's scent. The common DNA with those fragrances, as Molton Brown is doing very nice bath fringe, the scents are very clean. You can really smell in this fragrance a bit that shower jelly type of vibe, but in a very much more luxurious way. It's a different type of budget as well from Creed. Creed is like £165 for 50 milliliters. In here you are £60 roughly. It's not as you know, luxurious as Creed will be, but it's got really a tone that is really nice. It's called Tobacco Absolute, but don't expect to have a Tobacco Absolute. For me, it has a little bit more of that bright cedar scent and a flowery tone as well, which is really refined. Smells a bit exotic. It's really for the guy in the office that is sitting by his computer and is dreaming of escaping and seeing a landscape. For me, you've got very that balsamic tone that is really kind of exotic. And really poetic as well, very clean. There's a touch of leather, but really it's not a deep, dark scent. It's not, it's quite uplifting, I would say. It's smooth, it's sexy, but it smells clean and it's not invasive. So perfect for the office. If you know Odebo from L'Occitane, it is kind of in that vibe. Third one I want to talk about is Fortis by Liquid Imaginaire. This one is the most edgy one, artistic one. It's something I would say a bit more risky as well. It's a bit more a creative fragrance. If you know Black Afghano from Nasomato, you might really enjoy that. I find this one's got a bit more complexity, however, than Black Afghano. It's a very mature, I would say, masculine tone as a backbone of the fragrance. And it's so nice because you've got a lot of personality without being too invasive. And what is really interesting with this is you get really a spiciness, really get that cumin note that is nearly yummy, perfectly balanced with a bit of saffron, slightly sugary, but not too much. You can really use that for a lot of things, going to the office easily and having a bit of mysterious, a lot of character vibe, and also going dinner, having a, you know, like a date. It's got a, like a very creative tone, but in all refinements, so I feel that it's not too overpowering for the office. And if you want really that creative, I don't want to have the same fragrance as everyone, you might be happy with that. Probably the scent of the guy that wants to take the job of the boss, probably. Creed is the boss and this one wants to take his position. Really interesting scent, slightly green, slightly woody, a bit spicy, really artistic. So I love that. One is a show value, so I said to you I wanted this list to be suiting for everyone, and I'm giving you, for me, a value that is safe and, for me, absolutely perfect for office, and it's Chanel Allure Edition Blanche. It's my favorite actually of the Allure range because it's got very that dandy style, and it's a perfect balance between something quite citrusy at the back, like very sharp lemon at the start, and then you go for a more creamy sandalwood. So it's really refined because there's not too much darkness, not too much citrus, is in the way between. It really makes me think of something a bit more dandy, stylish, I would say, for trendy man, modern, I would say, look that would be really good for the office. And again, it's got a very nice sillage, but it's not too overwhelming for other people, and you got that freshness that smells clean. So for me, it's ticking all the boxes of an office scent. And I could see someone like a bit more trendy, a bit seductive, that vibe. That the next one, the fifth one, is number 1999 from Histoire de Parfum. So this is something that I feel, for me, will be absolutely stunning for the office, because it's got a bit of what is nice with this one and change from the other one, it's got a bit of a vintage touch. It's really comforting, it's strong, but it's not overpowering. Smell that cinnamon vibe that is quite cocooning, and an iris note that gives a powderiness to the fragrance. So compared to the other one, this one is a bit more greener as well. You've got like very like a juniper, so it's greener. Smells like open air, but in a very classic way, and classy also way. Vetiver amber note gives like a lot of charm to this fragrance and a heaviness. It smells a bit delicious as well. Quite bright, it's very bright, but then dries down to something more greener and more earthy as well. If you like earthiness but in a very bright way, you might gonna really enjoy that. Absolutely classy. I would say a bit more mature than the other one. It makes me think nearly like fall, like the you know, fall season. That, yeah, it's beautiful even for summer, to be honest. Oh my god, it's so nice. If you're looking for something a bit different, more creative, you're gonna love that. Next one, and I wanted to go for an office, but for summer. And there's a lot of office summertime that we know. We could use Terre d'Hermès, for example. Terre d'Hermès could be a very nice office scent, for example. But I wanted to talk about something different, so I made my little research and I find you something different. And it's called Sidra from Domaine Privé, and I fell in love on this fragrance because it's absolutely simple. It's very refreshing. What is nice, it smells cedarwood, so very like lemon-like type of wood, and you've got a musky trail, so the musk gives like really like a cleanness and a very powdery tone to the fragrance. So imagine fruits with a powdery undertone. Dying. A little bit green as well with the cedar wood, but the citron at the beginning smells a bit sweet. It's like a sweet citron at the beginning, so very sharp, and then musky, so a bubble of softness and refreshing tone. It's nearly like a, I don't know, like a quite milky cocktail. So I wanted to go also for this video for all type of budget. So you had a bit of niche, you have extreme luxurious, you have things like that, but I wanted to talk about something ultra affordable, and I've talked about it quite often because I think it's so pretty. It's Zara Sandalwood. So if you're looking, like, it's around £12, so you know there's no risk to be taken, but if you want to like a pure sandalwood scent, and sandalwood for me is so classy, so it smells very creamy, but nearly like you've been shaving like or sharpening a wood, but ultra creamy, nearly like you're sharpening a pencil. If you like this type of scent, my god, it's so nice, and it's for me a lot of character with a lot of smoothiness, and I think it's important to have something quite smooth for the office because it's non-invasive, and it also like smells like just like a simple ingredient. I can really see a man with a suit and wearing just that casual fragrance would be really matching. So you know, you don't need sometimes to put the price on your fragrance, it's okay. Number 8, and I had to add a vetiver scent in this list, and it's my little 8-10 bomb from Nuit de Megève. What I like with this fragrance is it's quite a earthy, I would say, vetiver, but you do have that tonkabine inside, and the tonkabine gives like a more, like slightly more warmer tone. And I would say Aitenbon Nuit de Megève is a really nice scent if you want to start your journey into the niche fragrance and you're not too sure where to go. It is usually working because they are simple scents but very nicely blended and nicely done. And for me, like, vetiver is ultra classy, and when you're in the office you want something class, clean, not too invasive, and this is for me what it's like. It's quite like more romantic as well with this like powdery tone tonkabine. And you've got a little note of coffee as well, very, very discreet, but you've got it, and it really makes me think like, okay, like you arrive to the office having your little coffee and you're ready. Number 9 is a safe option. I think the most safest option with the Chanel of this list, and is YSL Yves Saint Laurent. It's La Nuit de l'Homme. La Nuit de l'Homme is not really matching the name for me because it doesn't smell that dark. Like, I would, there's a lot of scents to wear during the evening and stuff like that are much more darker, like, I don't know, like with a lot of character, and for me the evening is where you need to show off a little bit. This fragrance is not showing off for me. It's a nice combination of simple ingredients, lavender being a very classy ingredient for me, and I think like if you're in an office and you want a promotion as well, you need to be reassuring. They're really the sense of a masculinity, a normal masculinity like we see nowadays. It's really like very modern, and I feel this fragrance will always work on anyone. The cardamom in there is so yummy as well, nicely balanced with the lavender. So I feel if you're looking for a safe option, this one definitely. And the last one is something a bit more edgy. So I wanted a scent also that gives more personality, that smells gentleman-like but with a strong base and personality. And so I finish with Navitus, and it's the scent Lotus. I don't know if you say Lotus or Lotus. I'm gonna say in French, so it's gonna be Lotus. In, I think, elegant, and it's really like a distinguished modern approach of a very classic scent. Like, if you imagine like vintage gentleman scent, this is it, but modernized. And It's got a lot of depth, but very ingredients are usually not really common, like verbena, that gains that this greenness to your fragrance, so you really have a green undertone to this fragrance. The lavender is here, like a perfect barbershop scent, and a very bright opening with neroli oil. And what is nice is the dry down is a bit more greener, again with juniper berries, that for me is really flattering on men to have something greener, like nearly like this piney kind of scent. And then you have a dry down that is much more oriental to me. It smells like very woody, a bit warmer with vanilla. You've got really that ambery and warm oriental vibe inside. So pretty. You've got aromatic invasive touch at the beginning, greener, and then with the time you really get that oriental warm sensual and sexy vibe. So for me, if you want like a sexy warm gentleman scent, you can go for that. Really really good, and you really get something that is quite unique as well, which is nice. All right, so I finished the list today, so I hope you enjoyed it. For me, it was really nice actually, because I've done a lot of research for this one, especially for finding scent a bit different, except some that I think you always need to add some safe option. I really enjoy discover things, and I have so many samples at home, and I had so many that I never tried. So I really tried everything and was like, okay, what should a man be smelling like in an office for me? Tell me in the comments, what is your favorite office scent? I will be happy to read you. And it's always nice to share that together. Subscribe to my channel if it's not already done. And I will see you very soon. Bye now.